Music is timeless, and Davido's album has proven that. Today, I want to meet with one of the guys that produced two songs in that album. I will not tell you his name, but he's a very big guy, literally. So come with me, and let's see what he has for us.
Which thing you like to do in your soapy farm?
Why do you actually do shit?
Why would it play?
But Chelsea won't use.
Okay, I think he's aiming back.
Chelsea, we know they carry any cough like what you say.
You don't have to go that low. That's me in the gap.
Oh, yeah.
Bayern.
Okay. Oh, yeah. Wait, I need to go do now. Because if I use Bayern for you now with Chelsea, now you win. I win. You now they go to say,
no.
My team goes stronger.
Bayern.
Might use India for you.
So you play game a lot when you get the produce.
And yeah.
Including in combat.
So, yeah, they play game a lot now. Well, I'm bad. Not just FIFA.
Honestly,
on
a scale of 1 to 10, how good you take for FIFA?
FIFA? I will let our result rate me.
Before, make it in our face.
No, man, they put you on suspense. From 1 to 10, I play like 8.
That's very poor.
Yeah, it'd be very funny.
That's very, very poor. What do you think of that?
8.
Can't even rank among the best FIFA players.
What's your ranking?
Stick to producing hit size. Make aiming for us, okay?
Okay. I can't even say it's too much for me, sure, for you. If I do that, I don't do what I do. Let's go.
Say, in the name of your partner, Rich, everything for you, your TV turn Rich, your tagline initiating, you want to initiate Rich in this one.
All white to you.
So, for real, I need to know the inspiration behind that name.
Offside. So, back in the days, I used to be a rapper.
Wow.
Yeah. So, I was really big on hardcore rap and all. So, and my guys normally call me Rage because if I do all this rap competition, I'm not to.
You're rapping with anger.
I'm not to fall in well.
How many albums do you have out as a rapper?
I know me come as a rapper.
So, okay, as you know me come as a rapper, that was the reason you decided to transition into producing?
Not really. But as this call, you may be like, not really, but. I wanted to like produce my own songs.
Games.
Yeah, so that was why I started picking interest in.
You wanted to produce your own songs? Why? Right?
Because producing was so expensive there for me now. Couldn't you like pay producers and all? So
what was the first equipment you bought when you wanted to produce? Like, what was it? Do you remember?
Yeah, but. what was the first equipment I got? I got my laptop and headphones.
Which kind of laptop? Which one?
Okay. My issue with that laptop, if you see, I have a like briefcase.
Well, at least it's
yeah,
essential.
It was doing the job for me,
And kickstarting what you wanted to do, right?
Yeah, at that point, it was doing the job for me. So, I used to.
Are you the type that appreciates humble beginnings?
Yeah, I actually do, can't despise the days of your little beginning. Mm-hmm. I guess so, because it's not easy, understand. I used to play drums when I was in church.
Why is it that most of these big producers and big musicians, they only start from church?
I did choir for church, though.
Did they sing bars or time?
They sing soprano.
So wait, I can't go from soprano to rapping, first of all.
Bro, I need to be the spirit needs to do that type.
So what I'm saying here is that you have, like, you've had a musical inclination from
the church.
Time immemorial, like when you were a little baby. What was the first, what was the first song you ever heard that you felt like, I want to work in music, I want to do that thing?
Okay, I think that was a rap song.
Okay.
Yeah, and it's one Rugged Man song. Then you move your body, make you shake that thing. Oh, yeah. Yeah, so I used to like.
Time, no.
Yes, no, I used to like. I used to like know that rap from like A to Z. Yeah, you
I
know,
like I used to like Rugged Man and Nick, and he calls himself Mr. Raw now. Nigga Raw.
Yeah.
Obodo was a hit everywhere that especially in Benin City.
Yeah, it was a smash then. So that song, yeah, it picked up my
your interest in music.
Yeah, exactly.
So from the fact that you're also in the choir.
Yeah, then I wasn't even in the choir when I was like listening to those rap songs. Then, yeah. You know, I was like way younger that time around. Like, put on the sing, you know, understand?
Like, how old were you?
How
old were you when you joined the choir?
The choir. I think I was like 14. Yeah.
14. Okay.
Yeah, I was like 14.
Now, between me and you, we're not going to put this up on the camera. We think we can join choir now because of one thing.
Why did you say that? Because of fine girls.
Because when I joined choir, that's was where I joined.
You see, you get that shot. Nah, I didn't want to try to go set it. See, that's not. Bro, I actually joined because I loved music, you know. Yeah. I was really amazed anytime I see people playing drums, you know.
Yeah.
So, and my mama said, like, you know, that at church over. Mm. So, like, man, they play the drums, me, God bless you, they come extra, you know, stuff. She should really go there, arrange chairs, you know, this type of thing. So, started playing the drums from the church, you know. They don't even know how I sing that time. Oh.
Okay. You said, you know, the same how I sing.
No, I didn't sing in the wine in Arofu. I didn't sing all this time, but my people in the church, they don't know how they sing. They just know me as a drummer, you know, and stuff. So, now one time, like, you saw me sing for choir rehearsals. I all bust.
So you're just
I have that spirit. You understand? Start to sing. Because I started singing to Sue. I didn't normally switch. Sometimes I would sing. Sometimes I would play drums. But I used to love the drums. I still love the drums. But it's been a while I played the actual drum.
You program it now electronically. Yeah.
Exactly. So, and that's why if you listen to my beat, if you like, they notice the
drums. The drum pattern.
Exactly.
In your beat. Yeah.
So I always
make sure. After the initiating ready, the next thing is very good to do.
Bro, what's the range process? You know what I'm saying? But I mean, joke out. You know, it's all live.
Are they talking about the roots?
They feel, don't forget, give all the feel.
I like talking about the roots of, especially when it comes to music, because truly, yeah, nobody just come out of anywhere. So there's a story behind it. And so far we've talked about your foundation, you know. You spoke about your mom just now.
Yeah.
I had a feeling that you're married. You look like a mommy's boy. Yeah, see they blush. I just
now because I soft.
You look like a mommy's boy.
Actually, you know. Well,
are you your mom's favorite?
I don't know, but but she loves me, you know. I think she loves all of us equally. We're just three.
Yeah, but so she knows not this level that you are on right now with Davido and has she called you to congratulate you on the album or how does she feel?
She's so happy. Like yesterday now, So I actually sent her that song on WhatsApp.
Yeah.
You understand? Maybe she listened to her. So she hear her. So I should still hear her again for radio. She said, and this song my son saying produce language. So, you know, she was so happy now.
You know you were a rapper, so and so you have that kind of rapper culture that Mama, don't worry, I'm gonna take care of you. Are you one of those kind of rappers? So like I'm trying to link it with my next question. When she called you and she said, I heard your song, the song that you produced, how did you feel? Did you feel fulfilled? Like, yes, I'm making that proud.
Yeah, you know, I was happy, you know. I was filled with joy. Yeah, well, at the end of the day, man, you know, she'd always tell me, say, she knows, say, for this music piece, I'll go far away. But now sometimes she said she believes, she supports. Yeah. I think most people, their family, they support them. But me and my family actually support them.
So I just heard Unavailable.
Mm-hmm.
I heard your name there. Initiating the raid process.
Simply means that you're credited as one of the creators of that jam, which is going to be a global hit.
It's a global hit already.
It is, yes, it is a global hit. Now, talk me through the process of, first of all, how did you feel when, I don't know how it got to you, but when you got that call that, okay, OBO wants to work with you, what was that feeling like?
Man, it was awesome, you know, because I've always wanted to work with OBO, you know, but it just happened, you know, so it was, I got a call from my friend Magicsticks.
Magicsticks. Name is also on that.
Yeah, Magicsticks.
Yeah.
So we produced the song together.
Okay.
So I just called me on that. You hope you have some beat, you know? And he was like, you have a beat on ground.
I'm
like,
so you had it on ground since before?
Yeah.
Okay.
So it's on ground. Like, but it was incomplete.
Yeah.
Do you understand?
You were just playing around.
Yeah. You know, I'm like, I get beat to go. I never finish out.
Okay.
But I send the data and I made myself work on them. You know? I just sent data to Magicsticks, you know, he just worked on it. It was like, here everything I had to ram. Just send them, you know, more. It was crazy, you know.
Right.
You know, Magic, like, a bad guy.
Yeah, sure. So,
I was like, okay, it's going to send it over to Mobile, and send out to Mobile. You know, the next day, we just got a call that I should pull up by the studio.
So you went to his presence? You were with him?
I was present.
How did you feel? Did you feel, where did they call this English?
Starstruck.
Or based on you're big rich too, so you know.
That's so beautiful. I'm a person who are very good. I hope you, I'll be smiling for wearing this. So when I was there, I just try to coordinate myself. Do you understand? Not much as it felt like I should just jump out of my skin. Well, I just did, you know, my life. You understand? It was like,
Did you see Juju? Israel?
Was it? Ah, I see Juju now. Juju was in presence. You don't understand, you know. I saw Bio at that studio, I'm on. I saw my boss. I'm like, what's you, Bio? Baba fresh, anyhow.
Now, how long have you been? How many years have you put into producing?
It's been a while. Like 6 years.
6 years.
You know. And so I started producing for myself, you know. Yeah, I don't get my
said. To branch out.
Wait,
is this the first time you're producing for a big artist? Mm-hmm. Even though not big as OB, but like for artists.
Yeah, I produced a half phone for Bad Boy Tims.
Okay, I just.
Yeah. Okay. I produced Chocolates for Magics.
Okay, wow.
Or Magics and Maven Records.
Yeah. And most times people always say Magicsticks. And Michael's
Magics. He's an artist, and Magicsticks is a producer.
Yeah.
So they're like two different people.
Yeah.
Produced a couple of records, you know. I produced that, you know, that shit in Balagwada, shit in Bolibolo. Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
That was you?
The reshuffle.
Was your tagline there?
It's there.
Can you play your tagline or just the raw format?
Okay. I also want to give a big shout out to JP's production.
JP's.
Yeah, JP's produced there, Shake Body for Skills.
Okay.
And Banana for Slide. You know, make out for Bataraking.
Yeah.
JP, so shout out to him.
Okay. Yeah. So he was the one that said that word.
Yeah.
Shade and Rage.
Yeah. Wow. I
thought it was a girl.
No, you thought, I thought it was your word or something. I beg go. So I just told him, I need to go. Don't say Rage, I'll be here.
Yeah.
Then can just follow in, they just send me one.
Initiating Rage process.
So you did several ones.
Yeah. Which other one?
Initiating Rage process.
So now you will. Yeah. So I think there's still another one.
Initiating Rage process.
So I prefer to use this first one.
Initiating Rage process.
Hey. Play I'm continue now. These are just random beside me.
And do on now.
Yeah, well, play.
Hey. You can hear the drums that he's always talking about.
Thank you.
Now, I heard something.
Who they play the keys?
I play small, small.
You get everything you know Sabi do.
Okay, I don't know. I actually tried to like dwell.
There was one time I saw a video of you on your story, on your Instagram story. You were playing football and you were showing skills like this. Like,
okay, that is another thing I can do very well.
So maybe if producing did not work, you would have been a footballer.
Actually,
with this belief.
Never been. I didn't find that.
No. I've always been a fan of tattoos, so I liked it. This Rage is actually the first one I got.
The first one?
Yeah, the very first tattoo I ever liked. So, you know, when I did it, I liked it. It's very painful. Yeah, it is. Well, I have a very high threshold for pain.
Wow. Very into BDSM.
This man.
Okay, now let's get back to the music.
Okay.
Your sound, I don't know if it's just my ears.
Okay.
But your sound has this Amapiano vibe in it. What do you think about Amapiano? Because I just came back from a tour.
Okay.
You know, when I got to learn about Amapiano in South Africa and everything. And Amapiano is a genre that I've embraced. Now, what do you think about Amapiano and its acceptance in Nigeria and the future of Amapiano from Africa to the world?
Amapiano is a great sound, you know. First of all, I love Amapiano because of the way the beat swings, you know.
And the drums.
The drums, the shakers, you know. Amapiano, like, you have to, like, let's speak.
In video quality, you know. It's not everyone. People say, cheating track. Best mistake.
Yeah, so the shakers and everything, you know. So, to me, Amapiano is, like, it's, you know, when I'm listening to it, it's spiritual to me. Mm-hmm. You know, it has this whole African sounds and congas and percussions and all.
Yeah.
You know, and it's still going to make more waves. You know, more people are still going to know about Amapiano, you know.
So right now, do you have a, should I call it a favorite beat that you've made or a best beat that you've produced that you don't want to even... You don't want to give it out yet.
I wouldn't call it like it's my best beat because I do so many beats. Like every time I listen to one beat, it will bust my head. If I have now, it will bust my head.
Just give us 10 seconds of that beat.
Okay.
Now the script. Bro, what was that?
That's an 808 bass.
How do you like how did you have the inspiration to, you know, infuse 808 into that?
You'd be Pop Smoke.
You know, when I was just doing it, you know, the beats were just coming up like gradually, like rising and everything. So I just needed something that would just give the beat that hard drop, you know. So thought about adding a drum roll. I'm like, nah, it's too normal.
Yeah.
You know, I just always like, okay, let me try out one get to it sound, you know. I just tried it then.
Right now, guys, focus on me. I feel blessed because I just...
You are privileged.
Heard something exclusive that is not even out there yet. So put respect on my name. Put respect on my name. So what is next for Rage as regards to music and the producing, you know?
Well,
because now you see on your chain it says Big Rage, and like you've manifested that in reality now. What is next?
Well, just me doing my thing, Big Rage, more music, more hits, you know. Just creating music basically. I mean, that's my life, that's all that too. So
yeah.
Everybody should just watch out for that, you know. More sounds from me.
So now, earlier you talked about Magicsticks, and I have the idea that you guys are really close friends.
Very, very close.
We literally linked you up with Obadus.
Yeah.
How did you meet him? Where, like, how long have you known him?
Magicsticks?
Yeah.
Okay, I've known Magicsticks now for like, it's been 10 years, I think, if I'm not wrong. I knew him back then in school. It was like,
Which school?
And I went to Lagos State Polytechnic, Ikorodu. Why did he laugh? You know, so that's where I met Magic, you know. So he was the producer in our department. In fact, he was my personal producer when I was a rapper.
Okay.
Yeah, so he produces for me. So I think I even learned most of the things I'm doing now from Magic. You know, so shout out to Magic. He's a great guy, you know.
Shout out to Magic. Shout out to Marantz.
Quickly start put yourself inside.
Okay, so Rage, are you hungry? Make we go kitchen. You go cook for me today.
We said, are you hungry? Well, I didn't cook with me, I did chop. But if you want for me, you know, I'm
What was the process of producing this Picasso like? What did you have in mind when you were producing it? Was it going to be like a love song? Are you a lover boy?
I'm a lover boy. So the thing is, I just wanted to do the kind of chilled vibe that you could just be in your room, listen to Call to Your Babe, listen to me. So that was how I came about Picasso.
I use the song a lot.
Yeah, so, to rise.
In my marriage, yeah. I'm married anyway, so. I don't do it in marital.
After it.
Yeah. So I'm married, I'm legal.
Yeah. So that's how I made Picasso music, you know.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
So if I ask you to choose between Unavailable and Picasso, which one would you choose?
I don't have a favorite. I love both of them. You know, not different vibe now. So if I decide to hold them on some kind of party mood, I go here.
Now, a lot of people online said that logo sounded like Wizkid on that song, and that if it's proof that Wizkid and David can work together and the song will be a hit. Do you see that happening? Do you wish that to happen? Like seeing
it's gonna be super great for the whole Afrobeat culture, you know.
Yeah.
You know, these are like the biggest
and
artists in Africa, you know, coming together on the record.
On the record, yeah.
You know, it's gonna be mad. I know everybody's expecting that.
That's sure. We're waiting for the tour.
I mean, it's gonna be the time to be alive, no?
It will be. But how would you feel if you are called and said they call up your phone and they say, Alpha, Whiskey that David won't record this thing, give us beats.
Bro, that would be crazy, you know. You know, after that one, if I don't produce that one, I finish. My mission is done.
Your mission is
done. I will finish our closed laptop, hand out, and I'm done with this one. My soul, baby. I've been listening to Southie Soul lately. What I'm feeling lately, I don't know. So baby, draw me close the life Picasso. Tell me, say you got the man we know. Baby girl, you know I got the figure. Make us sing, I make you dance, I reload.